Hello everyone, it's nice to see you again. It's Minty Foxu and welcome back to my channel. A little update. I went to Kawaiikon this weekend and it went really well, but it was just super busy and I'm really, really tired. But yeah, I did live stream when I was at the convention. You might have seen me live streaming then. And you also might notice that my hair is a little bit shorter, and it's because I cut it for my Ram cosplay, even though I didn't really want to because I want to grow out my hair where it's like I have long pieces in the front and then the back is just short. But the things we do for cosplay, I didn't want to buy a wig, so I just cut my hair shorter, so I have to deal with Ram hair right now. Anyway, I would like to show you guys what I bought. Most of the time I spend at conventions is in the artist alley because I'm an artist myself. I really like looking at other artists' styles. And then I'm like, oh, I wish I could be that good. I want to be as good as them. And it really inspires me to keep doing better and better. Not only that, like, I just love their merch. It's amazing. So before I get to the question and answers of this video that you all gave me on Instagram and YouTube, I'm going to show you some of the stuff I got. If you're not interested, please just skip this part of the video and go straight to the questions and answers. Anyway, let me show you what I got. I'll just show you, like, my favoriteest thing first is... I got this amazing bag. So every year, there's this artist there that I really, really, really like. She does amazing art of like foxes, and of course, since I'm a Foxu, I'm like, shit, yeah, I want fucking fox art. But she also does like Pokemon art and all different kinds, and she's really good at like watercolors. It's just amazing. She has to be like my favorite artist in the artist alley, but maybe just in general, like I really, really like her art. Usually I'm kind of picky about the kind of art style I like, but when I saw this bag, look at it, look at this bag, and tell me it's not amazing. Tell me this is not amazing, look at this. I'm pretty sure I showed this in my live stream as well, but I'm gonna show it here. For all you people who didn't see the live stream, look at this bag, look how amazing this is. There's a Bulbasaur, there's an Eevee, there's a Squirtle, there's a Glaceon, there's a Jolteon, Sylveon, Vaporeon, Espeon, Leafeon, Flareon, and Umbreon. Now, it's really cool, and it even has this like nice print in the back here. And then like has a zipper, and then it's magnetic. See? So magnetic clasps. And then I bought, other stuff I bought is, I got a Ram pin, because obviously I am Ram from ReZero. And then my friend Blushy Bun bought me a Glaceon, because I really like Glaceon. And then I just attached a bunch of my stuff to it. We also have, if you want to see the booklet for Kawaiikon, we got this. It's kind of like messed up because it was in my bag. What would you call this, event schedule thing? And it has all like the people who came, like the bands, what autographs you can get. This is the map of Kawaiikon's convention center. We've got, these are all the people who, we're guests. So we get like Baby the Star Shine Bright clothing line, which is like a Lolita Harajuku clothing line. We got voice actors. We got this guy, he came, Joe Inoue. He came, I think, last year. And he sings one of the songs in like a Naruto, one of the Naruto endings or something like that. And he came last year too, and he did really well, so I guess he decided to come again this year. I didn't watch his concert, but I saw Hanafugets. They're super good. I actually took some videos of their concert, and I really, really liked it. I recommend, if you've never heard of them, definitely you should look them up. They're really cool. It's like kind of old style Japanese music, but yeah. And then we have like the autograph schedule. We got the video room schedules, like what anime and movies they play. Exhibitors, artists, so they have a list of all the artists. Oh, talking about artists, I should show you the business card of the lady of who made this bag, so you guys can look her up and give her some love. Sorry if the camera is a little off. My camera fell out of its, what's it called, tripod? And so I had to fix it. Let me show you her business card. So this is her business card. This is like the kind of art she draws, and I really love it. And her name is, let's see if I can get it on camera, Carrie Corrine. And that's her information. She does really cute foxes and other stuff like that. And there's a ton of other artists too that I got cards for, but we'll just talk about this one for now because otherwise this is going to be a super long video. So, other than this bag, I also got... I didn't buy too many things. Usually I buy more than this when I go to conventions every year, but I was kind of one low on money because I have to save it for like cosplays and stuff for you guys. And two, I don't know, I just didn't feel like buying that much this year. But anyway, I got this cute little bag, also by the same artist. So the artist who made this bag, business card I just showed you, she made this cute little bag. And just look at her art, it's amazing, I love it. It's like, she does really well with watercolor. And it's just amazing. And I'm like, oh, I could put my makeup in here. I can do a lot of stuff with this, it's beautiful, let's get it. So I did that. And then I got some little stuff, like, let's see. I got some cute little, if you know what washi tape is, I got some cute little kitty washi tape. And the washi tape apparently, like, tells a little story. So if you look at them, it's like, here's the cats sitting in the rain. Here they are here eating fish together. And it's just really cute. It's super fucking cute. And then I got my friend Blushy Bun gave me a Daenerys pin from Game of Thrones because she's my favorite character and I plan to cosplay her sometime. And then because I was cosplaying Sailor Neptune, I got a Sailor Neptune. Sailor Neptune. That cosplay, I loved it. It was amazing and fun to do. But oh my god, I almost died. I forgot to bring really comfy tights or socks and I was wearing really, really high stiletto heels and it was a pointed one too, like the pointed toe area, and it was awful. I don't want to talk about it anymore, but I also got a mouse pad of Sesshomaru. If you know the anime Inuyasha, Sesshomaru was always my favorite character, like my man crush, because I have girl crushes too, but he is my man crush from Inuyasha. And then we also got some posters. So we got, if you guys know the game Fire Emblem, I am like a diehard fan of that game, especially for the DS ones, like Awakening and I think I'm playing Rebirth right now. Oh my god, look at this. It's Takumi. Now, he's not like my favorite character or anything, but the art, he's just so beautiful. Like, look at that. How could you not? How could you not, really? And there was like a deal. And in the background, you could probably see that's a Link one over there that we got from my friend because it was like 3 for a certain price. So I was like, okay, well, you can have the third one. And then this is Kaneki from Tokyo Ghoul. And I thought this one was really nice too. Oh, wait, no, I have one more thing that I got. See, I didn't really get that much this time. I got Kari from Digimon, a bookmark, because Kari was always my favorite character. Anyway, enough talking about Con. Let's get to the questions and answers, shall we? So, some of the questions you guys asked me. But the first one is from Sick225 or 225, however you want me to say it. And you ask, how tall am I? I am 5'4". Kind of, maybe like a little bit taller than that, maybe like close to 5'5", but I'm pretty sure I'm 5'4". What kind of music do you listen to? I mostly listen to Visual K, but I've always listened to like metal, hardcore music like that. I'm gonna list a bunch of bands because it's kind of hard to like define the genre sometimes. For Visual K, my favorite band is Diora. I also like Nocturnal Bloodlust, Div, Royce, Kodomo Dragon, Morgan, Meiji Bray, The Gazette, Killineth, Dada Aroma, Disrain, Sick 2, Kamijo. Kamijo used to be part of the band Versailles before they broke up. Gackt, Scapegoat, Xia Xia. And Arlequin, and there's another one. I can go on and on. There's a lot of Visual K bands out there, but let's just leave it at that. In general, for like Western music, I like metal, post-hardcore, grunge, industrial goth, classic metal. So I would say I'm gonna give you a big list of random bands I listen to. Marilyn Manson is one. Mindless Self-Indulgence, All That Remains, Emily Autumn, Sleeping With Sirens, Pierce the Veil, Bring Me the Horizon, Trivium, Bullet for My Valentine, Killswitch Engage, AFI, Stone Sour, Slipknot, Korn, Disturbed. Blind Fool Love is one I found out like within this year. It's like an Italian band, but I really like them. I think it's fucking cool. Him, Chiodos, Black Veil Brides, Rise Against, etc., etc. I could go on forever. Hopefully that's enough bands. The third question, this one is by, I don't know if I'm saying your name right, but it's Kanajed. It's K-H-A-N-A-J-E-D. And they ask, what is your sexual orientation? My sexual orientation is that I'm bi. I'm demisexual bi, meaning I'm usually not sexually attracted to people. Like, I don't look at people. I might think people are attractive, and I'd be like, oh, they're really nice looking, or they're really good looking. But I don't see it in a way of like, oh, I want to go fuck that person. It's kind of hard to explain, I guess, but basically, I like boys and girls. And the thing is, gender doesn't matter that much to me. I kind of lean more towards girls. I don't know why, they're just like super pretty, right? But like about the demisexual thing, basically I have to create a bond with someone, or I have to kind of get to know that person really well and feel really open and close to that person for me to want to do anything with them sexually. So it's not like I think you're attractive and then I'm like, oh yeah, I want to do stuff with you. I don't get that urge for some reason. I thought that was normal for everyone, and then I realized it's a thing, like that's what demisexual is, and I'm like, oh, okay. Because I didn't realize this, yeah. Anyway, let's go to the next question. The fourth question is by Gil_Dragonslayer, and they say, can I find you on X videos? No, you cannot. I do not do nudes and I do not do porn at all. I'm strictly a model cosplayer. I don't do any of that other stuff. Yeah, let's just end it at that. My fifth question is by AmyGen7. I'm sorry if I said that wrong. What's your favorite breed of cat? My favorite breed of cat is Munchkins, Scottish Folds, Sphinxes, or Siamese. Munchkins probably first because they have the cute little legs and it's adorable, but I feel bad sort of because I feel like they probably have medical problems from that. The sixth question is from Black Dahlia. And they ask, if the world had a national 6-hour purge, would you be able to wreak havoc or would you hide? That's a very interesting question, and I have an interesting answer for you. In my nature, I am not really a violent or angry person. I'm actually pretty chill, and it takes a lot to make me upset. I would probably just hide in that kind of situation. However, I am known for holding grudges. If you wrong me in a really, really terrible way, like betray me in some way, then yeah, chances are I'm gonna come after you. So I would probably go out to seek revenge if that was the case. If you really did something that horrible to me and I had a chance, like a 6-hour purge, I'm like, let's go. They also ask, what's your favorite movie? My two favorite movies are The Crow and Hannibal Rising. I love Hannibal Rising. I hope you guys know the movie Hannibal Rising. It's basically the prequel to all the Hannibal series movies, stuff like that. The other question was, do you like rain? I like the sound of rain. It's really calming and I like to like sleep during that time. It's great cuddle weather, but I don't want to be in the rain. One is because my hair is naturally wavy and I don't want to deal with that. That and it's just, I don't want to be wet and sticky and stuff. It's no. The next question is by Alberto Falcon. I'm sorry if I said that wrong again. What's your favorite game genre? I like a lot of different games. Some would be like RPGs, fighting games. One of my favorite fighting games growing up was Soul Calibur. Especially 2 and 3, I was just all over that. In 2, my favorite character was Taki and Shanghua and Talum. And then in 3, my favorite character was Tira. For the most part, just Tira. And then I also like hack and slash games. So games like Dynasty Warriors, Samurai Warriors, 99 Knights. Those kind of games, I love those. They're amazing. Like, I spent most of my childhood playing Dynasty Warriors 4, and I would not leave the TV. I would just be playing that, like, all day. I was always loved PlayStation, like PlayStation 2. A lot of my life I spent playing PlayStation 2. And then it's when PlayStation 3 and 4 came out, it was kind of hard because they're pretty expensive. And that's when I kind of switched to PC gaming because Steam is so cheap. I also like God and Sandbox games, so I like games like Age of Empires, Age of Mythology, I like sim games, like The Sims. The game Black and White was a good God game. Basically, I like lots of different games, but the one kind of game I won't play is FPS. I don't like shooting games, I'm bad at it, I don't like I don't like the camera, I don't like aiming, I don't like shooting, I just don't want it, I don't want it. The next question is from Guzelman, I think is your name, Guzelman. How long have you been a gamer? I have been a gamer for as long as I remember. I remember playing, like, the old school Mario games on, I don't even know what console it was, it was super fucking old. It was like when gaming was just like little pixels on a screen. I used to play it in the basement of my old house with my older brother, because basically I got into gaming because I had an older brother who played games a lot, and things like Final Fantasy X, that's because he played that game, and I was like, that looks amazing, I want to play, or Final Fantasy VII, and basically, I've been in gaming ever since I was like, maybe 5 years old, and ever since then, it's just been like a thing for me. I've never really stopped. I might have switched consoles, but I never stopped gaming. Another question from Gosselman is, cosplay looks so fun. Do you get into character role as well when you are all dressed up? For the most part, I will say yes. If the character has a really strong kind of personality, I will try. But the thing is, I can't stop the kind of personality I have. So if I'm walking around in the artist alley and I see something super cute, I'm gonna be like, oh, even if I'm playing, like, let's say Sephiroth, if I'm cosplaying, like, Sephiroth, and of course Sephiroth isn't gonna be like, oh my god, there's a cat over there, but, yeah, but anyway, if I'm, like, taking photos or something like that, then yeah, I'm not gonna be, like, if I'm supposed to be a tough character. I am also very shy, and I'm also very bad at acting. Funnily enough, yesterday, someone asked me to be in a video, and they asked me to dance, and I was like, you might be asking the wrong person, because I'm not good at dancing, I am not good at acting, and basically, he wanted to spin me around, dip me, and then kiss me on the cheek. You can just say that the spinning and the dipping, and it did not look natural at all, and I feel very bad for probably ruining that person's video. The next question was from the same person, what is your favorite outfit when you're in cosplay mode? I'm not quite sure what exactly you mean, but it varies because I always like doing new cosplays. I really like extravagant and over-the-top ones. I don't like looking that normal, so if it's just like a schoolgirl outfit, like I like schoolgirl outfits, but I wear those normally. Like I don't see that always as cosplay to me because a lot of the clothes I wear are already kind of costumey, so if I'm dressing up in a costume, has to be like super costumey, something I'm not gonna wear on a daily basis. That's basically what I like the most, but I mean, if it's a character I really like, if it's like Toru Honda from Fruits Baskets, her outfit is super basic, probably more basic than what I would normally wear, but since I like that character a lot, yeah, I'd probably cosplay her. Do you have a job aside from doing YouTube? I used to work in a bakery. It was actually like a Japanese cake shop, and I was working in the kitchen as an assistant baker. Basically, I would help decorate pastries, I would help make cakes and stuff. I don't have a degree in this, I don't know what I'm doing in it, but I know some basic cooking stuff and baking stuff, and they basically taught me the rest. It was really fun and I liked it, but it didn't fit my lifestyle in the end, and it became a point where I was like, I want to do a lot more. I wanted to do a lot more with my art, and I wanted to do a lot more with, like, all these aspirations I had, and I really just wasn't happy. And one of my friends was like, you should do Instagram, you would become so popular on Instagram. And I was like, I don't know, like, I think I should just stick to drawing. I'm not, like, a much of a people person. I'm not very good at that kind of stuff. I didn't even think I don't have that much self-confidence, to be honest. And, but the thing is, they set me up an account, and they're like, do it, try it. And then I got into it, and I was like, oh, wow, like, I'm actually doing well. People actually like my content. And then that's kind of what made me start doing more with it. And, like, now I have, like, 6,000 followers. I never, ever, ever thought I would have that many. I thank you so much for that. I thought I was going to have, like, at most 100. It's crazy how things happen. If I had not quit my job, this could have never been. We would not be having this kind of conversation. Have you started a bonfire with lava? No, I don't think I have. Can you fly? Only in my dreams or on an airplane. The next question from Junicorn the Third, I think is your name. What type of man do you like? That's kind of a tricky question because I'm bi. Because of that, I usually prefer feminine guys because I'm attracted to girls too. And so, like, I see the good in both genders, but I definitely prefer more feminine guys just because I also do like girls. So I'm not really into, like, super manly looking men with, like, muscles and stuff. I like more slender guys, good sense of style and hair. That's probably why I like Visual K so much. They're very girly, kind of, the guys. So, I don't know. I would just say probably Visual K look, goth look, more feminine looking. Lady Silverclaws, hi, by the way, asks, what did you do before Instagram and YouTube? Before this, basically, I was saying I worked in a Japanese bakery, and I basically also, I did art on the side on Etsy, and I sold commissioned art, basically. People would say, draw me this, and then I would draw them that. A lot of the time, it would be, like, commissions for video game characters, like Overwatch characters, stuff like that. It wasn't, like, a lot of money, though, that I would get from it, and even now, I don't get a lot of money from this, and I am struggling. I'm really struggling, but, I mean, I feel like if I invest the time and the effort and I hold through, I can do it. I can make this. My goal is to make this a living. As impossible as that seems, I'm going to try. Dark Sargasso, I think that's your name, asks, are you planning a trip anytime soon? Not really. I never really go on vacations often, but I do love to travel. Like, I'm from England, so of course I like to travel back to England and check things out. When it comes to vacations, because I already live in Hawaii, I don't really like the sun, but I mean, there's vacation stuff to do here, and my vacations are more like going out with my friends. Like, we all plan, like, months ahead to do this one big thing. Like, we either do a breakout room where we try to break out of a room together. Like, I had one posted. It was, like, a horror one we did last time. And Kawaiikon, that was like a vacation to me too. It was awesome, and I met a lot of interesting people. I met another Instagrammer named May Opa, I think her name was. She's also from Hawaii, and she was really nice to run into, so that was really fun. And I just hope I can do more conventions and cosplays in the future, and a huge goal of mine would just to be able to do cosplays all around the country. Dreams. We'll get there one day, hopefully. And I love doing YouTube, and I hope you enjoy my content, and I always am up for suggestions and criticism. So anyway, that was the last question. I hope you all have a good day, and thank you all for watching. I love you guys so much. Minty, Foxy, Papa, Chew!